Amrapali was a famous and attractive woman who lived during the period of Gautam Buddha. They were all standing in golden chariots at the gate of her palace because she was so gorgeous. Even the most powerful kings had to wait to meet her. She was a prostitute, but she had amassed enough wealth to buy kingdoms. But deep inside, she was suffering in that lovely physique. There was also a lovely soul yearning for love. People dubbed her City Bride, which translates to the life of the town. She was standing on her balcony one day when she noticed a young Buddhist monk with nothing except a pleading bowl, yet he had a powerful presence, awareness, and elegance. He captivated her from the moment she saw him. "Monk, accept my meal at my house," she raced down to him. After she brought him dinner, the monk accepted her invitation. Amrapali stated that the rainy season will begin in 3 days, and that she would want to invite you to stay in her home for 4 months. Buddhist monks do not migrate during the rainy season. Instead, they stay in one area for 4 months. They move typically for 8 months and cannot stay more than 3 days in one place. The young monk said, "I'll ask my master if I can come." He quickly withdrew after saying this, before the young monk could reach the congregation. When his other monks saw him run to Buddha, they suggested he needed to be stopped. Amrapali has offered him to remain in her home for 4 months, and a monk being in a prostitute's home is not appropriate. Buddha urged them to be silent and wait for him. The young monk approached Buddha, touched his feet, and told him the entire story. He stated that a woman had offered me to stay in her home for 4 months during the rainy season. Every monk will spend 4 months dwelling in someone's home. I, too, will be required to remain somewhere for 4 months. As a result, I need your permission to go and remain there. I'll only go if you let me. Buddha looked him in the eyes and replied, "You may stay." It was terrifying for the other monks. Thousands of monks present couldn't believe Buddha had permitted a monk to reside in a prostitute's home. "This is not right," remarked an elderly monk. "This man is concealing a reality. He claims to be a lady, but Amrapali has invited him. She is not a woman, she is a prostitute. I know, and because he has not uttered the word prostitute, I am allowing him to be there. He respects her." After 3 days, the young monk departed to live with an Amrapali, and the other monks resumed their chattering. Buddha advised them to be silent. 4 months will pass, and I have faith in my monk. I glanced into his eyes and saw no yearning. If a monk's meditation is profound, prostitutes will alter him. If his meditation is shallow, prostitutes may transform him. It's now all about meditation and physical attractiveness. Simply wait 4 months. Despite the disciples' belief that Buddha is overly trustworthy, this man is too young, and Amrapali is too attractive. He's already taking an unnecessary risk. After 4 months, a young monk approached Buddha and touched his feet. Following him was Amrapali, who stroked Buddha's feet and said, "I tried everything I could to seduce this young monk, but it was all for naught. Instead, he persuaded me that genuine life is only found in discovering your actual self. Now I wish to devote all my goods to your monk's commune." And it is reported that Amrapali eventually became one of the enlightened female monks among Buddhist pupils. We can observe in our own lives that in order to maintain control over the sexual ideas that arise in our minds, we must first remove sexual desire. But instead of removing sexual want, we begin fulfilling it by indulging in it because we lack control over our mind. That is why many young people begin to engage in unnatural sex such as masturbation, but they fail to see that our sperm is our energy. We can achieve enormous success in any sector of life if we can conserve this energy. To date, all of the world's great people have reached greatness by preserving their sperm energy. To preserve your sperm, you must not repress your sexual drive, but rather eradicate it via meditation and positive thinking. You may easily manage the sexual ideas that arise in your head if your meditation is powerful and you have control over your mind. Please subscribe to my channel Lessons of Life and press the bell notification icon.